We are designers, Sebastian and Matthias, mm-hmm. and we are the founders of Norgram. We used to work together at Hello Monday, mm-hmm. and we're really happy about that, but also wanted to really bring a focus to the design aesthetic and the design style that we stand for, while at the same time really wanting to work more together. So we had the idea of actually, the beginning thoughts of starting a studio mm-hmm. together, where we could work more together.
That would probably be IKEA Place, augmented reality app that we did for IKEA, or together with IKEA and Space 10, their future innovation lab. There were so many different disciplines included in that project that it also spanned almost the whole
half of the year, six months.
The last 6 months we've been working on that.
And it's also such a defining project because you're working with a new technology that we didn't know how to approach. So there was a lot of like UX and UI questions that actually were brought up, like can we actually do this the normal way, or like how do we need to go about it? So I think for us as a small studio, it has been defining, but also like learning wise, it has been pretty defining for us.
Yeah, and also like the 2D versus 3D, how do you integrate UI components into 3D and 2D as well, and have them work together.
Well, I think in general, I think our role as a designer, and I think in the designer's role in general, is really about the experience. Like, how do you make a good experience? It might be experimental, but still you need like people to be able to use it. Sometimes it's more elitist, and sometimes it has a more mass appeal, which IKEA Place, for instance, has. Mm-hmm. Like, that needs to be used by a lot of different people. So I think there we had to pull ourselves a little bit away from perhaps some of the more experimental stuff we do, and accept that what was new and experimental already was the fact that you could place 3D objects through your phone. Mm-hmm. Like, that's already a huge step. So where we would normally push the boundaries a lot, we actually pulled a little bit the other way, like how can we really just bring clarity so people feel comfortable and have a natural experience when they need to deal with like something new like AR. Mm-hmm. But I think all in all for us, it's not necessarily about the technology, but it's really, it comes down to that experience, no matter what we're working on essentially.
That's also a good question. I think one of the most important things is to display the objects in the right way, and also what do you call that? Tell the story in the right way also, and also like the user experience is also a big part of it as well, I think.
It's also, I think, like, for us, we didn't actually start a studio to deal with all the new technology. We actually started a new studio, Norgram, to focus on our beliefs in design and our aesthetic as well. And I think in some way we also just happened to land in the spot of like dealing with AR and also getting a lot of questions around voice recognition and all those stuff. And to some extent, I don't even think that we are like the best at it, and sometimes I also get stressed out of like looking at the internet and like this technology is going to disrupt this and that. But I think really it's our role, and the importance for designers is also just to digest it, look through it, and also understand that yes, you have AR and voice, but if you create something that's not like a good experience, then it doesn't matter. And I mean, if you look at voice assistants and stuff like Google Home and Alexa and stuff like that, 70% of people who use it to play music. So it also tells like, do we actually need it, or like what is, I'm not sure voice recognition is necessarily like the thing that's going to disrupt everything. That doesn't mean that there aren't nice use cases for it and it can be done in a nice way, but it's like, again, always find that human touch and like a natural way of interacting with it. That's the crucial part with any new technology.
And the purpose of it also.
Yeah, the purpose.
It's not that far long ago that we started using Sketch, for example, instead of Photoshop for doing like designs. And that's like, it's really fast compared to Photoshop, we think. So that's a super important tool for us right now because of it really enhanced our speed, our workflow in designing. And for like Matthias and I are sitting in Matthias is sitting in Copenhagen and I'm sitting in Aarhus, so we work remotely with each other. So we have a lot of Skype time or FaceTime or whatever. We use Slack and so on. We use a lot of different communication tools depending on which project that we're working on. On an overall level, we use Google Docs for like exchanging designs and explorations, and also like that's our main present tool and so on. And then we use Principle also for doing like smaller animations and stuff like that.
I think in general we have the main challenge that we're in two different cities, and so I would say our most important tools are the ones that make sure that we are collaborating. Mm. So it's stuff like as well like Trello, keeping track of tasks and stuff like that. Like Sebastian said, Google Docs to if we're working on the same thing, we can always like see what we're working on and pull it in there, and then we can call each other and talk about it. So I think actually tools for us is like the necessity and the reason why it's possible to do what we do. Otherwise, it would have been kind of hard.
Yeah. And also it's also the reason why I think we can work with larger clients and not just like smaller setups.
I would say regarding what you said around like what new tools to try, I'm thinking like I kind of don't want more tools. I want to be smarter on how we use them.
Less tools.
But then I also, and this is super boring, but the other day, because we're just two people, so we also have to make proposals ourselves and budgets and stuff. Yeah. I really need a tool that can help me with that, because like we're not that kind of guys.
No, we need something simple for that.
Yeah. It's a tough question. I think even the word web design for me is like years ago in some way. I mean, we do a lot of other stuff than just web design. For me, I mean, we see a lot of like these traditional experience sites that has been around for long and we all love to doing. We did too. And like the briefs are not really there anymore for that type of stuff. But I also really believe, just to go back to the fact that you're like making a good experience. Yes, like making experience websites shouldn't be like the big thing, but I think it has its place for the right things. Like it's again that fact, like not everybody should be doing AR, not everybody should be doing an app, because it's really about like why are you doing it. Whereas like the IKEA thing, like it makes sense to try out furniture. But perhaps standing with your phone in front of a table and there's like this crazy adventurous game on the table that you can hardly see, maybe I actually want to play that on a big monitor instead. Like, so it's for me, it's the role is obviously broader than web design, it's digital design in general, but I also think it's just about like those right use cases, which I think from the history of web design, you know, it started with technology and now you can do this, and it goes into these trends where, okay, now you can do apps, so everybody needs to do apps. And I think all these new medias and platforms that I invented needs to sort of fall into its place and be there, so we can like figure out, okay, what is the best way to go, rather than like, this is the new thing, or this is like what's gonna be big.
I think it's super important. I've been to maybe 3 awards conference, and I really enjoy like meeting the same people actually year after year, even though I also meet new people. But it's just nice to talk to people that are behind the other agencies, to be honest, instead of just sit and browse different award sites and say, okay, they look really nice, these guys, but what are actually behind the screens on the other end. And just get new inputs and stuff like that, and maybe new business partners, or like if you meet agency who has more focus on one thing, and you can maybe like team up on a different project or something like that. So I think it's really valid to go to a conference like this to talk to people. Mm.
Getting outside the screen, basically.
Yeah. Just meeting in general and talking with people. Yeah. It's really nice. I think it's really nice to get acknowledgement,
yeah, recognition
from the industry, and I also like we use it to also push ourselves, like looking at like different sites that win awards. It's also like a nice bar to aim for. But yeah, other than that, I think that's.
I think that's for us it. At least, like the main thing of it is probably like just remembering that we need to push ourselves every time.
Yeah.
It's not like the specific award in itself. It's actually more the fact that you have almost kind of a tool that you need to remember to push against and to be better and better. Mm. Yeah.